With a huge new announcement, Softr now allows us to use container blocks inside of building our apps. This means that we can have two or more blocks side by side on the exact same row when we build our Softr applications. So if learning more about this new feature is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, allowing you to build complex apps without a single line of code. As I mentioned in this video, we're going to be taking a look at the new feature from Softr all about container blocks. We're going to be doing a deep dive on these new containers, going through step by step and showcasing all of the different details within the new feature. Before we get into it, though, I want to invite you to follow along with me in your own Softr account. Also, if you have not already become a paid Softr user, Softr has given us a promo code that you can use to get 1 month of Pro Softr subscription for free. Go ahead and follow the instructions on your screen to put that code in and get access to that Pro level account. Now, without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into things. We're going to start from scratch, and I'm going to start with the company intranet here. It really doesn't matter what template you're using, or if you're using your own. I'm going to be connecting a new data source. Let's do this, Airtable. Again, I'm just using the template so that we can go in and showcase the features of the container block. So we're going to go ahead and add a base. We will say all future and current bases. Let's go ahead and grant access. You've seen me do this probably many times before on the channel. We're going to copy the database into our Airtable account to make sure that we've granted access to Softr, and we will go back and then install the template. Now back in Softr, now that we've connected to the application, we can say go to the application, it will build it in the background, and we will load it right here. So the important thing here is that previously in Softr, we added blocks that would take up an entire row inside of our application. Even the templates, because they haven't yet been updated to reflect these new components, are the same way. You can see when I hover over each element in the older version of Softr, it's taking up that entire row. Right here, if we select this, we see this is a list details block, but it's taking up the whole row inside of our application. And if we're previewing this, of course, we're going to see that along the entire row of the app. And this is generally not what you're looking for. Yes, you have some control over putting this, you know, image to the side, putting the button down here, putting some text over here. But when you want to have different blocks, different components side by side, it was impossible to do with the old system. Well, now we can pop into Softr and add container blocks, and here's how we do it. So we come on down here to wherever we want to add the container, and we say add block. Now on the right-hand panel, we have a new option. It used to just say dynamic and static, and now we have container. So we can select container, and we can see that we can drop in this element, and we have a bunch of different options. We can go up to three different columns in our block, and they can be split up this way. So we have two columns, three columns of equal size, four columns, actually. I failed to mention that four column option. And then we get into the 1-2, the 2-1, the 1-3, the 3-1, 1-1-2, etc. So a lot of different options in terms of how you're laying out the data. You now have control over what you're bringing in here. So the sky's the limit. Let's go ahead and pop in a 1-2 block. I'm going to use this one and drop it in. And so now we see that we've got the two different components split up as we selected with the 1-2 ratio here. So this one is the width of one, and this is double that width. And then inside of these, we can now add the dynamic or static blocks. And note that this is fantastic for breaking down some sorts of dashboards and things of that nature. Before, if you were using, you know, numeric counts, line charts, pie charts, they were going row by row. It wasn't that simple to see your data. Now you can drop this in and actually look at aggregated data right here. But it doesn't have to be aggregated data. You can literally use any of the different blocks here, both dynamic blocks, looking at charts, summary cards, list details, etc., or the static blocks. So you can go in with CTA, custom code, or something else. So let's go ahead and pop some stuff in here. I will bring in a list. Let me drop a list in here on this side. And so now we see that that list is just filling that section of the block. Now, of course, I've got this database as part of the template here. I could select a table to display specific information. Let's do employees, actually. And again, this is just an example. This is not necessarily how I would build this, but as an example, we could bring in the cover media. There's probably an image for the different employees. We could bring that in. We already have their name and title coming in. So this is great. We're able now to see the different employees getting added in on this block, but maybe on the side here, we want to add something else. So now we have the capability of putting something side by side with the list of employees. Also note that with your container blocks, if you want to keep things kind of at the same height, you can also leverage the list settings here. So I might reduce this, let's say, to only 4 items at a time. That way we're not getting that very long list and people can click see more. And this just makes it a little bit easier on the presentation side. Now over here on the left-hand side, of course, we can add something else. We could bring in a grid, we could do a chart, maybe some comments. I mean, really, again, it's up to us how we want to structure this. The key takeaway is that we now have this flexibility of having things on the same row. Let's just throw in a pie chart. I don't even necessarily know what I want to map it to. So we can just leave it like that. And if we were to kind of zoom out of this, you know, we could see then that we now have these blocks side by side, giving us this new functionality. Now, you don't have to go in and recreate all your blocks from scratch. What I want to point out, one of the key features of this, is that we can move things in and out of our container blocks. Let's dive into that. I'm going to actually remove this pie chart. Up in the block options, I will click the drop down here and select delete. And I'll delete this block. Let's say there was already another block on my page that I liked and I wanted to move it into this container block. Well, I would come up to that block itself and right here to the left of the duplicate and to the right of the move up is an option that says currently this block type is not supported inside a container. And of course that makes sense. This particular block that I'm looking at is more of a hero block with the image and then the text on the side with a call to action. That would be a weird one to put inside of a container. But if I had other list items, other details, I would be able to, on this particular option, move it inside the block. Let's take this new block that we just created as an example of this. So if we select the options here, we see that we can move it to the left, we can move it to the right, or we can move it out. So if this were out, let's say taking up an entire row by itself, I could then choose to move it into the container once I've built the container. So if you are converting from the rows and you're moving into the container elements, what you will first want to do is create the container block that you have envisioned and then take your existing blocks and move them into it as follows. You'll just go move inside container and it will ask you which container, if you have multiple on the page, do you want to put it inside? And here you would say column container one. And you see it adds it here. And from here, you can move it to the right or to the left and make sure that it's arranged the way that you envision. So again, key takeaways here are that you can move blocks in and out of containers, provided that they are supported in the containers. You can also move them to the right or left once they're inside. And you can leverage the number of items shown inside of the block to make sure that it doesn't get too long for your container. Now, one other thought is that if you select the container itself, you can go through and change the style if after the fact you think, maybe I don't want the 1, 2, and I want to go with 2 columns of equal size, you can just make that selection, right? Just simply select or highlight the layout that you've chosen, and you can make a change. You also have title and subtitle options here, so they can go inside of the container, not necessarily inside of the blocks within the container. So you get your title and subtitle here at the top. And of course, our styling over here on the container will choose the size of the title and subtitle, as well as the alignment. It'll also choose the roundness of the corners on the block, if it has a shadow, if it has a border. So a lot of styling options, top padding, bottom padding. And as is true with all the different blocks in Softr, we also have visibility permissions here. So we can choose our users and who is able to see this. Is it everybody? Are we hiding the block under certain conditions, etc.? Something to note is that we cannot control the visibility of the block within the container. Whatever the container rules are, all of the blocks will follow that same rule. So if you built a container with two different items and you said, I want the item on the left to always be visible and the item on the right to be conditionally visible, this is not possible. The container itself is what holds the rules for the visibility. The individual blocks within the container inherit the visibility from the container. As you see here, I'm selecting the block inside the container. Visibility is grayed out. And it says that the blocks inside a container will follow the visibility rules of their container. So that's it. There's a lot to explore with these new containers. I've already started implementing them in numerous different Softr apps, and they're looking pretty good. Let me know in the comments below what value you are getting from this. Of course, if you like what you learned here and you want to learn more about no code, I do have a free training I would invite you to check out. Grab our free automation training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. That's it for this one. I hope you got a ton of value out of this. If you did, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel. But most importantly, keep on building.